Well, here we are. We're here on the last date, the last guy, but hopefully not least, because I have a mental note of how I ranked the guys. And although Quest had me just choked up and giggling like a little schoolgirl, when I tell y'all, Quest has my heart in a chokehold. Quest has my heart in a chokehold. But we are here now talking to NakedToaster. And as always, there is something else going on. Now, they were panicking and freaking out about something. Maybe someone hacked the server. Seems like NakedToaster is under the impression that we're being watched while we're in this server. So, you know, everybody went off to sleep. Everybody's gone to bed. Night owl dropped off. And I said, everyone's gone. He said, huh, I'm still here, with the little smiley face, of course, because they all are adorable like that. Where was I at? Said, I'm not sure I completely understand everything that's going on. NakedToaster said, here, a call will be faster. Come join the call channel. Take your time, but also don't. I only have a few minutes to spare. Keep in mind that he is the Final Fantasy nerd in the chat, but him and like XYX's Matt Close together. Sure, I'll be there. And he kind of put the little thing there. Now, before I start the call, I have the window open, so I need to close it because I turned the heat on. It was like 20 degrees, but the temperature starting to go up and it's starting to get hot in here. So I'm gonna close the window real quick. Just give me a second. Hold on. We all want to talk to NakedToaster. Give me a second. Almost done. Almost done. Almost done. Almost done. Almost done. Woo! Okay. Sorry for all the squeaking and moving around and stuff. Here we go. Hey. I said hey.
1 second.
Oh, he's got a very... By the way, someone informed me, because I said I like the tall guys, and I said that I found out that XYX was extremely tall. Apparently, he is the tallest, so now I'm curious how tall he is.
Okay, so.
Oh my goodness, he's so cute.
Oh, your camera's on too?
Well.
Hello, welcome to our very happy and normal fan server.
He's so cute. He has pink hair. Oh my god. And look at his background. There's Big Morty back there. Oh my god. It's so cute. So, I do have some questions.
Shoot.
Okay. So, you think we're being watched?
Of course I do. The amount of censorship in here has to mean someone has a vested interest.
Okay. Do you have any theories on who it is?
No, I don't.
Hey, well, people would say that my theory, I don't know who it is, but my theory would be Quest, because he was first here. I don't want to believe that he made this server and was kind of like being the, you know, censor person, but then I kind of want to believe it because like, my man got power, but... We're not talking to Quest right now. I might go back through and do Quest's thing again. How long have you been in the server?
Me? I don't know. 2 years or so.
Okay.
But I didn't join because of Blooming Panic.
Then why join?
Let's just say I read a story very similar to this one. I did eventually read Bloomic, though. But it doesn't matter. 2 years. Yep. I've been here 2 years.
He is so nonchalant, and it's making me smile because I'm like, what are you hiding under that nonchalant little exterior you got out there? I like it. How did you find the server?
It was a little different for me than everyone else.
I need to find my glasses. Sorry, I was looking around for my glasses because without my glasses, my vision fades in and out and stuff.
But I didn't still find the server randomly online. Someone emailed me a link.
Okay. Whoa. Do you still have that email?
I do. The email is nonsense, though.
For some reason it skipped on its own. I didn't do that. Why would someone email a direct link to you?
No clue. But it's definitely unsettling. Any other questions?
Yeah, like, why do you have elf ears? They're so cute. And why is your hair pink? It's cute. No, that's it. Thanks.
Sure. Any less confused?
Well...
Who knows, though? Maybe it'll all clear up soon and we'll get a final chapter.
I love his glasses. He already scales a little bit higher. Cause I just like how he... I like how he presents himself. He already scales higher than XYX. Oh my goodness. This is so hard. My phone's ringing, sorry. That won't make you give up on finding out if the author is in here though, right?
Well, yeah, it won't. But I have other things I need to think about right now, besides this fucked up server. I'm gonna call it a night. You sure you're good?
Unless you want to stay with me. Yeah, I'm good.
All right.
Y'all knew the moment that y'all came here. If you've watched all of the episodes that I have posted, y'all know that these lady boners are serious, okay, on this channel, okay? I don't want nobody saying nothing like, wow, you're being a little too horny. Okay, then go make your own channel and be less horny. Like, I'm just, don't come at me, okay?
99.
Oh, he said 99, that's so cute. Good night. Whew, okay. That was night one, and it's on to night two. Now, again, I'm not gonna show the whole thing. One, because I want you guys to really go download this game. It's a free game. Support these people that make these games. And, I mean, while you're supporting me, I appreciate it. Uh-oh. Somebody got restricted. Okay. So, while you're supporting me, I do appreciate it. However, these people put hard work and effort into their stuff. I want you guys to support these people as well. So... I'm not going to show you like all the talking. I'm just going to give you like a short breakdown of everything that happened. Other than that, I'm just kind of wanting you guys to go and experience this game yourself. Secretly get your lady bonus yourself and tell me, like, you know, the bad endings, the good endings, because I'm going to do them on my own. But if I forget to do them on my own, I want you guys to tell me. Like, hey, you said you're gonna get the good endings and the bad endings. Did you ever get them and stuff? And we can talk about it in the comment section below. But still, I'm just saying, you guys need to experience this game yourself. And I am putting the game in the description box below so you guys can find this game. But oh my god, like, this game got me like cheesing. Unless you're not into visual novels, I get it. I'm a variety gamer, so I get that most people who come to my channel kind of don't. This is going on a little long. I'm so sorry, I'm rambling. But a lot of people that come to my channel come for different things. Like, some people come and see, like, oh, she uploaded The Walking Dead. Oh, she uploaded Danganronpa. Oh, she uploaded this. Oh, she uploads that. So, yeah, I get it. But it's on to the next part. Okay, I'm going to record this because it started to get cute. So, everybody's, like, kind of stressing. As you guys can see, Night Owl is stressing. Everybody is freaking out and whatever. And NakedToaster is like, okay, I'm going to, you know, let's do a little thing, a little test on a scale of 1 to 10 of how stressed out are you, okay? He said, Voyia, I said yes. He said, why should we answer 10 for everything? Why do you just answer 10 for everything? Because Night Owl is freaking out or whatever. So I said, yeah. He said, perfect. Okay, first scenario. You're alone in the woods, trying to find your way back to the main road. You're following your phone's GPS. Your phone has reception? Shut the F up, okay? You're following your GPS, and 2 miles away from the road, your phone dies. I have a charger. Well, you don't hear. That's stupid. Okay, Voyia, and Solo, how stressed are you? I'm terrified of the dark. So I would be like around a 8 because I would be forcing myself to stay calm in the situation. But I'm letting y'all know I'd be freaking out. I would be like inside internally screaming, but on the outside I'd be like, okay, let's figure it out, let's find our way back. So I'd be a nine. I'd be a well nine. That's kind of a nine for me, because if you think about it, that is just a tad bit like it's just too scary. It's okay, Voyia, me too. I suppose I'd be ranked two. Wow, Solo, okay. LOL. That's admittedly lower than I anticipated. Okay, you think I need a phone to get out of the forest? Old man advantage. LOL, okay. How about you're called into your boss's office, and she sits you down and tell you they found drugs in your office drawer. I wouldn't do that. I swear to God, Tutu. Okay, relax. Tutu, let him have his moment. In this scenario, there aren't your drugs and you don't know how they got there, and your boss looks like she wants to fire you. So on a scale of 1 to 10, how anxious are you? Personally, I don't do drugs. Don't do drugs, kids. So, I would be about a 4. I'd be about a 3. A 3. Because honestly, I'd be like, that's not mine. I don't know who put it in my drawer. I don't know how to prove that I didn't put it in my drawer, but I don't know how to prove that I didn't put it in my drawer. So, the only thing I could do is tell y'all to check some cameras. And I would leave it at that, but I don't do drugs and my system is extremely weak. So, me and that is a no-no. So, I'd be a 3. Like, a 3 is not that bad. A 3 is like, maybe. Really? Interesting. Oh, that one's easy. A 1. Solo, please take my very scientific poll seriously. I'm not sure he's lying, Toast. There's no way you are that calm. Life is too short to let little things like that get you down. Yee. There's always something better ahead. Maybe. Or something worse. Maybe. You know? I mean, they're both right. But I'm kind of with Solo on this one. If you didn't do it, why are you freaking out? Why are you panicking? The only thing I would do is I'd be like, if you think it's mine, test me. Test my hand, get some residue off my hand of it, you know, test my system, see if it's in my system, if you think it's mine. So though, I wish you were my grandpa. Maybe I am. I had quite the time when I was young and stronger, if you know what I mean. Ew, oh my god. So we're back into the fan dump. Oh my god, this is so cute. So I don't think this is important, but if something important comes up, I will show you guys. So I don't think this is like super important, but it put a smile on my face reading it. So again, remember I told you Naked Toaster is into Final Fantasy. So he sent the link. Then stop. And I was like, I'm not clicking it. And I said, ooh, it looks interesting. Ladies and gentlemen, we got us. We got one. That's so funny. And then they all were kind of like freaking out. Yes, my lord. Do we invite her? Of course, my lord. Invite me where? Because I'm a little curious to where y'all trying to invite me. Good luck, Voyia. Oh, God. Juicy gamers. Okay, here. Oh. What is this? A private channel? Because being in here, both of them, I mean, XYX is cute. Naked Toaster's cute. I'm okay with this. Locked to only those seriously committed to gaming. Are you seriously committed? I don't know which one to choose. I'll just do this. You heard the man. This is very important. Can can I know what part of gaming I am committing to? Towards, excuse me. Final Fantasy. What else, Final Fantasy? Can I think about it? Oh God, boy, let's talk it out face to face. Oh, a call, that I can do. Okay, are you not joining XYX? Because it seems like XYX is kind of backing off. And again, I can only assume that at this point, XYX is not like used to us. So here's our next call though. No, thank you. XYX doesn't join calls. He's an idiot though, so it's no loss. I'll be waiting. Here we go.
Let's see. Hello.
Ooh.
I've already set up a subscription for you while I was waiting.
You did.
It took forever to join calls, by the way.
Because I be talking to my audience, okay? Just like you like Final Fantasy, you know, I have people that watch this game and watching me play, okay? So you can just relax, okay? Sorry. No, I don't. Sorry.
Sure, sure. I set your login info and password to be...
Oh, God. That scared me.
Seriously?
Oh, he got censored.
Ugh.
Whoa. So, that's what censoring in the live call?
Very inconvenient.
Does that mean someone is listening to us right now?
It's possible, but I doubt it. It's probably some software they have set up, though, that is listening to our calls.
Oof.
Yeah. Oof. Anyway, looks like you'll have to set up the account yourself.
Well, I mean, you could just, like, email me the information.
Are you on the website?
I'm talking to you. That's more important. No.
What?
Okay, look at him blushing.
No, we're talking because you need to play this game.
Oh, he's so cute. The one thing that most women like, it's not as far as like finding out your deepest, darkest secrets when I say this. But the one thing that women like is making a man blush, embarrassing him, but not like how I've been seeing on TikTok, how women are taking their men or husbands and being like, oh, my man got doo-doo in his drawers. Oh, my God, my man sleep all day. Oh, my God, he played video games and he's 40 years old. Like, no, it's not like that. It's like more like us catching you off guard and making you blush like this. Ugh. When I tell you some of us ladies love making men blush like this. We love making men blush like this. Oh, my God.
More important. What the hell? At least open the site later, okay?
Okay. Maybe. What can you do to convince me?
You... Well... Have you played any MMOs before?
A lot, but I'll probably tell you now. I want to keep him interested, right? And with this one, I'm going to take more of a... I want you to teach me how to play, though. No, this would be my first one.
Well, but lucky you. This is the only one you need to play anyway. All you need to get started is a keyboard, a mouse... and a few hours a week of free time.
Well, I think I can do that.
Easy enough, right?
Not sure if I can manage the free time part.
Oh, right. I forgot. You chose to work at an insane job.
Wow.
Sorry. That actually came off more rude than I intended.
It was kind of rude. It was definitely kind of rude. Wow.
Sorry. Sorry. So, why do you work there anyway?
Well, the pay is pretty good. My co-workers are really nice. I miss them. No, the pay is pretty good.
I'm pretty sure you could find pay like that elsewhere, no matter how good it is.
You say that, but when I tell you that, when I tell you that I have been looking for work because YouTube don't pay me enough. By the way, YouTube, if you start promoting my channel, you know, I get more followers and stuff. I can devote my time to this and be 100% into this. So I'm just saying, you know, we can make a deal here, YouTube. I'm just saying. But anyways, when I tell you that, because I'm not making enough on YouTube, I was trying to look for, you know, something so I can do this and YouTube. There are no jobs hiring. And I thought it was me and stuff until I started getting like intel. I can't tell y'all my intel, y'all know. But anyways, I got some insight into a job and they said that they have like some certain jobs and stuff have special things that they have where it just filters out your resume. And if it doesn't fit what they have in their filter thing, it never make it to HR whatsoever. That is insane. People are really hurting out here for work and money, and you guys are making it so hard on people. There are people that have jobs right now that don't want to work. I love working. I love working for what I want and go for it and everything. It is just insane. It's just insane.
Is that really the reason?
I'm not entirely sure. I'm usually too tired to give it much thought.
So that's how they keep you satisfied, huh? No time to think about your situation.
Yeah. It could be worse, right?
It could also be better.
It could be great. But, you know, life isn't always like that. It's not black and white. Either you have a job or you don't have a job. It's black, white, purple, and orange, and green. Either you have a job or you're trying to get a job and they tell you no, but then they tell you they need people and then you go and apply and they be like, now we're good. We're good.
It's okay to be a little stressed, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Take it from me. It's better to aim for a happy life.
You know what? He just went, he might be tied for just this sentence alone. He might be tied with Quest because I love a man that be like, you know what, I want you to be happy. I don't want you sitting here stressing over this and that and stuff. Like, oh my god. Whew. Yeah. Are you happy playing games all day?
Hey, I don't play all day.
You gotta sleep sometimes.
But yes.
I mean, when I tell you that for me, YouTube kind of makes my day. There are times where I'm recording, and I know a lot of you guys catch on to that, and you can hear it in my voice, where I'm recording, and I just don't have the energy, and for some reason, it just jolts out of me when I'm recording and stuff. And then when you guys leave comments and likes, and I get new followers and stuff, my God, when I tell you, it is just... It makes me feel amazing. It makes me feel amazing. It makes me want to create more. It makes me want to do more.
You have a nice laugh. It's warm.
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
No problem. Don't think that I've given up on getting you to play, though. You haven't convinced me yet that you're inconvincible.
Okay. Feel free to keep trying, Toasty.
Dangerous, giving me your permission like that. But it's late. I don't want to keep you up too late if you have a long day ahead of you.
But I don't mind staying up with you. Oh. Like, I am enjoying this conversation.
Really? Well, then this is me being responsible for you.
And by the way, I love your pink hair tie. Boo!
Would you rather I was irresponsible?
Yes. I think that'd be a little fun, don't you?
I'll keep that in mind. Good night.
Good night, Toasty. this man is so tied with Quest. Not above Quest yet, but he is tied with Quest. Most definitely. Not only are you tall, but you're a nerd and you're cute, and I cannot wait to see the ending for this one. I'm so excited. Okay, so we got a little message from Toasty in the Juicy Gamers. He said, Voyia, are you online? Yes, I am online. Hey, so how was work? It was a little better today. He's worried about me. Oh, that's so cute. Oh, God. Him in Quest, I swear. Oh, nice. Why's that? I only had to work 1 hour late instead of 3 hours. I guess we take the wins when we can. A win is a win. A win is a win. And any type of, I know a lot of us are working towards something, and some of us are just working just to work. But when I tell you that a win is a win, you know, even if you worked all day and you can't seem to like just get it together, but then you get like, I don't know, extra money on your check or anything like that. Like I said, a win is a win. Take all your little blessings and thank God that you got them. Toasty. Yeah. What do you do for work? I don't think you ever told me. Oh, yeah. I guess I don't really like to talk about it. Oh, unemployed. Moving on. Why is that? Well, when people hear what I what I do, it alienates them a bit. I don't know. I won't judge you, Toasty. Pinky swear. Oh, well, I own a company. This man is a company owner. Oh my God. Silicon Valley style company. Like CEO? Yeah, CEO. I can tell you already see me a little differently. No, of course not. Why would I see you different when you're still the same? I've never read a message more unconvincing. Sorry. I kind of see you differently in a good way, though. Question mark. You work long hours too, right? I used to back when I hated myself. To be fair though, it's a lot easier for me to decide to work fewer hours than for you to do that. Man, being a CEO really sounds easy. Uh-huh, sure. Still though, you would work less if you just, you know, got a different job. Are you hiring? I wouldn't mind being your secretary if you're hiring. My secretary? I pulled off a pretty nice pencil skirt. Want to see? What the hell? But for real, why not move on? I don't know. Change is hard. I see. Like changing jobs? Yep. Boy, changing jobs is so hard. Because you're always taking that, especially if you don't have something to fall back on. Oh my God, that's got to be the scariest thing. And you're the breadwinner and no one else can catch your back if, you know, you fall. That's got to be the scariest thing. That is so scary. Oh God. If you don't know, be thankful. Just be thankful. I see. There's a lot of uncertainty when you change jobs or even when you work itself change. Excuse me. I suppose. My God, I'm so sorry. I was trying to hold that in. I suppose. It happens. I can relate. How? Without going too into the weeds, my partner would like me to accept a buyout. It's the smartest decision for the company, for our future, but the company is important to you? Yeah. Really important, actually. It's like my baby. ew. I guess that was the best way to put it, but ew. I built it from the ground up, and that is okay to feel that way. Using my own algorithms from when I was a teenager, so even though I know I'll probably agree in the end because it's better all around, it feels like, I don't know, a terrible boss. Yeah, absolutely. Sorry, y'all had to hear the squeak. I had to move my mic forward. But you built something from the ground up, and now someone's asking you to give it away. It's like raising your child and your child leaves and never comes back. It's like, no, it has to feel bad. Yeah, feels like that. Idiot, don't sell. F your team. Howdy, X. Sure. Oh, wait. Sorry, I missed a part. There we go. Nello. I'm JK, so to me. Sure, can you afford it? Maybe. I mean, you never know. I mean, he probably can. No, he's not kidding. Wait, what? Oh, do you need a secretary? No. Nope, no. We're all for Toast. We're not gonna flirt with X, even though X has me kind of wrapped around his finger being a bad boy. Wait, what? Don't worry about it. So wait, sorry. You made an algorithm? Like an AI? Is that wrong? Well, I guess that's one term for it. I kind of hate that buzzword. Okay, so that's what happened. I'm so sorry, you guys. I had to lean in closer because I lost my glasses, but I didn't. I was like, wait a second, I'm a little lost. Did I miss something? But yeah, I did miss something at the top. Not necessarily. You made a game, huh? Did you? Hey, stop it. You made a game? I guess it's from high school, so it wasn't anything special. Oh, come on, don't sell yourself short. Yeah, like a lot of people be like, oh, I can do this. Oh, but it's nothing. Stop that. You on this channel, big auntie, sister, little sister, big sister, I don't care what you think of me as, I am going to boost you. You do not sell yourself short like that, okay? That goes for Toast. That goes for you guys as well. I didn't really say it's becoming the basics for a company some days. I'm happy I am where I am now, but I care more about the work than the glory. That sounds ignorant. I get what you mean. No worries. Thanks. So, how did you do it? Oh, God. Can we do it in a call? Because I don't have my glasses on, so it's going to be really hard for me to see it. Well, yes, several. I mean, yes, several, Jesus. Yes, reveal your secrets. Oh, my God. Give them all to me without giving too much away. It wasn't much more than what everyone else was doing. I was just better than they were. Very humble. Absolutely. Look, I don't know how else to put it. Do you still have that old adventure game? Maybe. Why? Want to play it? You gotta be for it. You gotta support your man. Play the game I made years ago? Come on. Let her try it. Man. Did you plug it into your server bot a while ago? Shite. I did. Didn't I? How the F did you remember that? I'm all knowing, idiot. So if I just type the command, the bot will start it up. Okay. Yeah, I mean, the bot was surprisingly simple to plug stuff into, so I spent like 10 minutes slapping it in there as a function. So he has been here a long time. Okay. So he's around like putting programs and stuff in it. And he, remember in Quest thing, he did say that, you know, he told Quest that, hey, don't use this server because, you know, people can find out your information. You messed around with the server bot? Oh, God. It's not that hard. You're kidding me. I tried it. It never lets me in. Had to make my own bots. Oh, that makes me think that Toast is maybe the server person, the one that's writing everything. Your own bots lets you in. Oh God. Oh wait, what happened? What happened? Sorry, it like jolted up on its own. Thank you. I knew you weren't as good as me in Epic. I knew it. Anyways, let's go to it's go time for adventure. Teenage Toaster style, LOL. I hope it's nothing cringy. Please, you've seen it already, dumbass. Go. Okay. Text, traveler. Adventure, okay, wild romance and tragic ends. I love this. The embark on the quest to the west. Living your small village, but leaving your small village behind. What is the name of your adventurer? Voyia. Okay. Will you be our adventurer today? Yes. Okay. Oh, God. This is going up for like 10 minutes now. I'm so sorry, you guys. I'm so sorry. With me not having my glasses on, me being a slow reader, all that stuff. Like, I'm so sorry, y'all. Yes. Welcome to your journey. Let's effing go, dude. Don't give them any tips. Me? Help them win? LOL. Is it difficult? I kind of want to know if it's difficult. Your journey will be difficult, but worth it in the end. Most things are value. Oh, God. I'm going to skip past me doing this. So we got done with his game. We started talking about it a little bit. He said he made it when he was a teenager, and he can make better things now. And we started talking about work and stuff and how Final Fantasy is his escape from the stress of work and how stressful things can possibly be for him. And then we started venting about our work and stuff and telling him that his game was amazing. And then he said, thank you, by the way, ever need someone to vent to about work, I'm always around to listen, just if you need it. Not that you need to tell me specifically, you can vent to anyone. It doesn't have to be me, but if you want it to be me, I'm here. I said that means a lot. Thank you, Toasty. You're welcome. I have to go, but talk to you later. Yeah, let's play some more of your games later. Because we put a pause on his game because, my God, it was kind of long. It wasn't super long, but it was kind of long. All right. And it's on to the next day. I am really enjoying talking to him. And it's Friday. A couple more days and it will be at the end. Okay, so we played a little bit more of Toaster's game. And then we started talking. Jesus Christ, my phone scared me. We started talking in the chat about how somebody made Italian characters in the general chat. Hopefully I can go back to them. Yeah. Somebody made Italian characters out of the original characters of the game. And Onion isn't falling for it or whatever. However, he asked me, did I believe him? I said, of course. And he asked me, did we want to call? And I said, yes, of course. So it's time for our third call. I think it's our third call.
Hey, thanks for joining. I know that was a little weird, but I really am telling the truth. Like I told you a few days ago, I really did read something else prior to Blooming Panic. It was just, well, as you can see, it was something a little weirder than Blooming Panic.
I see. Only a little weirder?
Okay, maybe a lot weirder.
I promise you I'd steal his hoodie. Especially because he's a tall boy. I think he's 6'4", which, oh my God. He's a tall boy. I would steal his hoodie so quick.
You want to know the most fucked part of it?
Okay. Definitely.
You know how in Bloomic, Lola's going through that weird plant transformation?
Right.
In Blunini, she's molding.
molding?
Pretty gross, huh?
That's so much darker than Bulimic.
Huh? Why is that?
She's rotting away instead of transforming. That's really bad. That's actually really bad.
Oh. That is pretty dark, now that I think about it.
Sometimes you need an outside source to think about something that you wouldn't think is so dark or whatever. So you'd be like, hey, isn't it funny how that bug is just laying on its back fighting? And then meanwhile, somebody's like, no, it's not. It's like, that bug is dying in the sun. He needs help. He needs to be flipped back over. Otherwise, he's going to die. Like, that's not funny. And then you look at it, you'd be like, you know what? Now that you say it like that, it's not funny at all. Not like they ruined your joke, but it gives you an outside, like, perspective of what you think is funny. And especially somebody like me, because I have dark humor, and I'll laugh at something that happened to me years ago. Like, I'll make a joke and be like, I remember when I got thrown in the pool and this boy tried to drown me. Oh my god, like like, I'm looking back on it now and it's so funny, because I was flailing my arms and screaming like, oh, help, help. And somebody's like, no, you could have freaking died, like, that's not funny. And then I look at it and be like, maybe that wasn't funny. Like, it's kind of like that. Yeah, so how did it end?
I suppose how you'd expect. She vanished.
No, poor Lola. What the hell is wrong with this author?
Yeah, I mean, we aren't sure how Bloomick was supposed to end, but it felt like it wasn't going to be that tragic. Anyway, I managed to find those short stories again. It looks like they were all written prior to the first chapter of Bloomick.
So the author just likes to reuse characters?
That's my guess. It had some similar plot points, though, which was odd. Like Nathaniel snapping at Lola.
Maybe they were trying to... I want to believe they're trying to perfect their craft. I just don't think it's that, though.
Yeah. Maybe they wanted to see which story style fit the characters better.
I guess. Italian food or urban fantasy.
Apparently a difficult choice for the author. I'm gonna keep digging, though. If I'm lucky, the author dropped some sort of hint or accidental clue as to who they are. Or maybe there's another alternate version of the story out there that will have even more clues.
This seems like a lot of work. Do you have time for that?
To be completely honest, not really. Really digging into my raid hours. But this is important to you, right?
You're doing it because of me?
Yeah, I am.
Oh my god. I have this in my life. I'm saying, like, I need this in my life, but I have this in my life, and oh my god. Please don't stop looking for Prince Charming, because I promise you he's out there. If Toast is your Prince Charming, I promise you this person's out here. This person is out here. I'm gonna swear to you.
Is that... does that make you uncomfortable? I don't mean anything by it.
No, I really appreciate it. That's sweet of you.
Sweet? It's nothing. I just know what it feels like to be losing something you care about, you know?
Yeah, I know. Thanks, Toasty.
No problem. I'll do my best to find out who the author is. I promise.
Oh my god. I'm in love. I am in love. You would think it's lust. It's not. This is love. Like, it'd be different if they were being more, like, sexual flirting, like, sexual flirtation type of thing. And you guys know what I'm talking about. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, look it up. But there's a difference between, you know, nice, soft flirting and then hardcore sexual flirting. There's a difference. And it's not a thin line. It's a thin line there, because it's flirting regardless. But it's such a big difference when someone's just soft flirting with you and it's melting your heart. They melting your heart without having to stare at your boobs or talk about how big they are or make a joke about, oh yeah, I'm gonna put your legs over your head. Because some women don't like flirting like that. Some of us like that soft flirting like this. And my God, like, I'm one of those girls. I am one of them. Not to suddenly change the topic, but you mentioned Nathaniel Nathaniel had me thinking,
About what?
I'm so sorry, guys. I'm trying to hold back this cough, but I'm losing my voice. You're the only one on the server who really likes him, huh?
Actually, until recently, Onion Thief was a fan too.
Really? That surprised me.
Sure was. But, I mean, you saw. Onion Thief can't stand humans with flaws.
It seems like Onion Thief is somebody I wouldn't even want to talk to, honestly. Not as a friend or, like, dating him. He's kind of like a stickler. That's not what he said.
I'm sure that's what he meant, though. I've always liked Nathaniel. Even in Blooming Panini, when he was just a bowl of delicious risotto.
You know, he sort of has a similar vibe as that elf from the adventure game.
Huh? That angry elf? No, he doesn't. Nathaniel is very calm and polite. You just have his recent outburst on your mind. Tisk tisk. But for the record, I like that angry elf as well. One of my favorite encounters.
I'm so curious about his backstory.
Well, maybe you'll get to see more of him. I think he shows up in a few other branches. But anyway, just like Nathaniel, I like how believable he is.
Nathaniel?
He's the most realistic character, personality-wise.
Or maybe he's just the one you relate to the most.
Well, I'd like to think I wouldn't yell at my partner like that. But I can empathize with the feeling of cracking.
Are you dating someone? I don't want to answer. I don't want to ask this because if you say yeah, then I'm gonna feel a shot in my heart.
No, I'm not dating anyone. Don't worry.
Oh, I could breathe. Whew, I could breathe. Don't worry.
That just slipped out. I don't know why I said that. Ignore that.
So, how would you treat your partner?
Oh, I'd like to believe I'd treat them pretty well, I guess. I've always been a sort of giver in past relationships.
Aww.
I like giving gifts and pampering the other person.
Aww. So your love language is giving gifts?
Love language? Yeah, sure, probably.
That is so sweet. Oh my God. I personally, my love language is giving gifts too. I have multiple love languages. I love giving gifts. I love complimenting and boosting my person and motivating them. You know, I love doing little small things, like even if it's just cooking dinner, even if it's just rubbing feet or massaging backs or running a bath or turning on the shower or setting out the clothes. That's my love language. My God. Like, I can relate.
What about you?
My love language?
Yeah. In previous relationships. I guess I know you've dated at least one asshole before. Was he the only one?
No. Yes. For me... No. No.
Oh, thank God. I'm glad you got to experience some hopefully better people. So, yeah. What about your love language?
My love language is physical touch. My love language is gifts, words of affirmation. Like, it's all of these. Like, I'm all of the above. Probably quality time and act of service.
Those are cozy. I can see that.
You can?
Yeah. You seem like the kind of person to really want to support whoever they're with.
Yeah. Aw, thank you.
Sure. I feel like I learned some fun things about you today. You're pretty interesting.
Me? I mean, you're pretty interesting yourself.
Of course. The girl who refuses to leave a backbreaking job and tries to extract bits of happiness from an online story. I think she's pretty intriguing.
Shut up.
That's getting late. You have a long day tomorrow, right?
But I want to keep talking to you.
Me too, you know? But tomorrow, you would be upset if you stayed up any later. Talk to you later.
Yeah, sweet dreams, Toasty.
Good night.
Oh, he's so cute! Oh my god. I just need to soak all this in while I, you know, start the next day. Because he is just too cute. Okay, so we just got done talking to Solo and... forgot to turn my heater off. We just got done talking to Solo and Solo was talking about how his wife passed away. And that he was going to bring her 4 or 5 or 6 bouquets, which is beautiful. It is so beautiful. And we were, you know, kind of happy that he was being more excited to see his wife. But we were curious why he wasn't mourning her. And he expressed that it was more of a celebration of her life because she lived such a long life. Solo is the oldest person in the group. Keep that in mind. So, you know, he's a grandpa. So he's like, yeah, she lived a full life except for when she was at our job and he told us to quit our job. And then Toast brought us over here and he asked us how we were feeling. I told him I'm feeling all right. Oh, excuse me. Solo seems very happy. Nice. Yeah, he is very happy all the time, actually. If I didn't know him, I'd be suspicious of it. I was going to offer you a call, but you'd probably rather get some sleep. Actually, I'd love to chat. I'll be in the call channel. I'll be there. So, here is maybe our last call. Maybe our last call. But you know, there's Sunday. This is Saturday, so it might be another call.
Hey, I realized that that sallow conversation got a little bit heavy. You doing all right?
Oh, he's checking on us. Huh? Yeah, I'm good. It's kind of a nice conversation, to be honest.
Okay, good. I thought so too, but I wanted to be sure.
No.
Salo's always been a future is brighter than you think sort of person. He's nice to have around the server.
Yeah, he is.
Makes me think sometimes that I'm overthinking my problems. I'm sure he wouldn't be as torn as I am.
About the buyout. What was the problem again?
You remembered? Yeah, the buyout. I still don't want to sell, but maybe I'd be more willing to let go if I had a sort of guarantee that I would be able to move past it.
Wouldn't that be nice? A guarantee for every choice you make?
It would. I wish I was able to fully embrace that mindset of letting things go when it's time.
Absolutely. Like, we don't know what the future holds for us. We could all be gone tomorrow. Or we can live full, happy lives and no one gets sick anymore and they find every cure for everything that could possibly kill you and people become, you know, one instead of it being like, this race hate this race, these people hate these people and all this other stuff. But just to have a guarantee that everything's gonna be all right, like, I wish someone would tell me, like, hey, continue doing YouTube. You're going to be like one of the biggest YouTubers in the world. You just keep it up and you got this. I would love that. I really would. And I would keep going and keep fighting. If it took me 30 years, 40 years, I would keep going. Yeah, me too.
Yeah. Speaking of, I did do some more digging around Bloomick.
You did?
Yeah. I couldn't stop thinking about it, to be honest. Barely slept much last night. But don't worry, I'll make up for the lost sleep tonight and refuse to get out of bed until 2 p.m. at the earliest.
I'm sure you don't lose too many daylight hours. Sorry, make sure. Why not sleep through the whole day? You've earned it.
Now that's an idea. But yeah, I looked around for more details on Bloomick, but it just got weirder and weirder the more I looked.
How so?
I think I found a really old, really early draft on a fiction site. But instead of a set of stories or one long web novel, it was a short story about Lola's transformation. No love interests, no college, just Lola sitting in a room contemplating her end.
That's even darker than Blue Nini was.
Right? Makes me wonder why it branched out into the weird, convoluted story it is today, given that the original premise has stayed the same all this time. Here, a quote. I closed my eyes, wishing I could go back to the me I once was, but I knew better than to dream of impossibilities. The story never goes into what the change was this time, just focuses on Lola's thoughts.
Interesting. Big.
Yeah, but the better thing? There was an author signature. Bloom.
Oh my god, a name?
Yeah. I'm gonna poke around a little and see what I can find with that. Might dig around the server too and see if there's any clues I missed.
Wouldn't June have found those ages ago?
She can't look as thoroughly as I can.
I mean,
can you imagine if I find another alternate universe, though? I wonder what else this Bloom person could write Lola into.
I'm dying to see what else you find for a weird alternate universe. Universes, to be honest.
I'm not sure how much weirder it could get from Italian food.
They could be all sticks. Have you ever seen a Little Curious? If I remember to put a picture of Little Curious up here, that show... That show is a drug trip, I swear. If you've never seen it before, I recommend just going to watch A Little Curious. It's a crazy show. Picture this. Booming bag. Vrooming, excuse me.
Vrooming?
Like cars.
What would Lola be? A Prius?
And Damien would be a Tesla? Oh, God. Nathan. And they think it would absolutely be a Volkswagen.
How the hell do you come up with something like that? Incredible.
Well, I didn't. The creator of this game did. That's why you guys should go download this game and support me and the creator. Just came to me while I was talking to you.
You're sweet.
And you're cute. Oh. This game is reading my mind. I didn't even know that was up there. Thanks, you're cute.
Cute? You think I'm cute? What the hell?
Oh, did I misread the situation?
No, wait, that's not...
Oh god, I did, didn't I? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to make you feel uncomfortable.
You did misread, I'm very, fine. I'm good. Great, even.
Wait, really?
Yeah. Shit. Why do you always make me feel like a teenager when I talk to you?
You're so adorable.
My heart feels like it's pounding out of my chest.
Same here.
This is usually where we say goodnight, but I don't really want to say it yet.
Oh god.
What about
my phone?
You?
Hold on, phone. Just 2 seconds. Just give me 2 seconds, I promise. What about you? Okay. I'm actually pretty tired. I'm gonna get out of here.
Really? That makes me really, really happy.
Aww.
Since you're staying up, I just want to say it. I'm interested in you. In, you know, that way. Is it safe to assume you feel the same way?
Yeah, I like you, Toasty.
Shit. You didn't even hesitate with that, huh?
Absolutely not. You are a breath of fresh air. Oh my god, my phone. I'm so sorry, y'all. I really need to take that phone call, but I want to finish this. I feel like I've made it plenty obvious, so it's not very hard for me to say.
Obvious? Maybe it was to other people, but I'm a little slow to notice these kinds of things. I would have said something sooner if I'd noticed.
I'm curious, how much sooner?
That's a little embarrassing to admit.
Please?
It was after that call we had, where I tried to sign you up to play 14.
Oh my god!
The way you talked about Blumick, and your honesty about your job, it kind of stuck with me. I felt like we understood each other's struggles with letting go of things that mattered to us. And then the next day, when you empathized with my buyout problem, it sealed the deal.
Aww.
And, you're really, really pretty. Your last boyfriend was an absolute idiot.
That is so sweet. That is so sweet. I'm so happy. You're gonna make me blush.
Oh, finally, I'm not the one embarrassed. Yes! Now you're even cuter. I like this side of you.
Shut up. One second, you guys. I'm sorry. One second. I'm so sorry, you guys. I'm so sorry. Just.
Can I ask you what you first liked about me? I'm really curious.
You're cute, you're tall, I loved your scrunchie, I'm gonna steal your sweater.
Especially since I'm shocked you like me at all.
Really? Shocked?
Maybe pleasantly surprised is a better way to put it.
I liked... you're on a company guy, your sense of humor, your hair. Your sense of humor.
I'm glad. The world is better with more of your laughter in it.
Keep me laughing for a while, right?
Of course. Whatever you'd like.
Oh my god!
I'd love to keep you up later, but I'd feel too guilty.
No!
It's okay. There's always tomorrow. Sleep well, and, thank you.
For what? For liking you?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Oh my god, his little giggle is adorable.
God, I have to hang up before I say something somehow even cringier. Good night. I'll see you tomorrow.
Oh my god, yeah, definitely. Good night. Oh my god, he's too cute. And I'm sorry my phone's been ringing through all of this, and I'm trying to quiet it down. But it's on to the last day. Okay, I know I sound a little bit different, but it is the next day for me. Well, the day I will be uploading this, because I had to start... I had to start way over, kind of, not really. And then I had something important to do, so I ended up spending the rest of my day doing that and didn't finish recording. So this is the day I will be uploading this, and I'm recording this. But apparently our romance, wild romance, tragic ends. Last we left off, the hero had made a stubborn a pass at the stubborn elf and was ready to continue their journey, though the dense grove of trees. Did you start it up? Oh, hey, Voyia. Hey. Did you have a good day? I did. Thanks for asking. Toaster, you're acting a little weird. Because I don't remember, you know, playing it, as a matter of fact. I remember not playing it at all. I was happy to hear. What the F? Ew. Sorry. Didn't see you online. ? Anyways, no, I didn't start up the bot, Voyia. ? Please. Now we continue. Wait, Toaster, did you break Boombot? No. I was poking around the server code, but I swear I didn't break anything. Color me unconvinced. It does sound very suspicious, Toaster. I'm sorry. God. As you continue, you start to hear noises. Is that rustling? Faintly, you can make out several voices whispering, armed, here. I can smell the iron on them. That's weird. What are they trying to threaten? What are they trying to threaten us with? That I can't read today. A little ignorant, if you ask me. What is this? The little forest demons? What did I say about spoilers? I'm just trying to get some context. Yes, it's them. Thank you. You call out. What do you say? I don't really want to play right now, though. Toasty, should I just play? Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the game. Because, again, like I told you guys, we were playing a whole entire game together. But, like, a lot of stuff started happening. And then we ended up talking. And you guys saw that conversation. So, yeah. Well, now's not a great time, I think. Let's just travel our oasis. It didn't register it. You take your time pondering your option. Oh God, so the bot won't pause. And you put traveling oasis, it's supposed to pause the game so we can continue talking or whatever without it interrupting or whatever. And it's not pausing, which is a bad thing. It's not even reacting when Voyia says something out of turn anymore. I knew it. You broke it. No. It's all right. I'll just play along. Yeah, that's perfectly fine. Hey, I can hear you, you know. Forgive me, you guys. I just got done eating. And I didn't want to burp in you guys' ear. Oh, they can hear us? We're shaking in our boots. Won't you put your hammer down? You look quite the idiot. Jesus, that's messed up. You definitely do. Put it down. Do you need their words? Do you heed their words or abandon your hammer? Definitely not, I swear to God. Okay, no, definitely not. This is gonna be a little weird. So, I don't feel like I guess you guys can watch this. I'm not gonna, like, skip past it or anything. I'm just gonna play it out. So you ignore the demands of a marched on. You know better, than to obey mysterious whispers in the forest. They chant after you and try to coerce you over and over into dropping your weapon, but you pay them no heed. As hours drag on, however, your patience begin to crack as they seem to only get livelier and livelier. Go on, drop it. It's rather heavy, isn't it? Wouldn't you like to rest and take a break? If you don't rest soon, you might stumble and hurt yourself, or worse. But if you let yourself stop, if you let yourself stop and whisper, and the whispers show themselves, it could be worse. Don't! Oh, so you can spoil, but I can't. So, I don't know what he did to the bot. Maybe he was trying to do something crazy. He's trying to figure out who's controlling Blooming Panic. But whatever it is, it's kind of scaring everybody. No, I meant don't spoil it for them. Oh, lol. Well, I'm gonna keep going. Well, good luck, lol. Wait, was that wrong? Now I feel like I did something wrong now. Oh no. Wrong or not, you continue to trek onwards. Then, as if suddenly entrance, the giggling around you stops and the eerie silence fills the woods. Huh. That's not what usually happens. Isn't it supposed to split off here? I'm going to dig into the bot a bit more closely and then I usually do. So it's kind of turning into something different. The bot is kind of thinking on its own. It's bugging out hard today. Glancing around the treetops, you don't see... Jeez, I need my glasses. You don't see any creatures lurking about. Not a single gaze from... seems to be fixed upon you any longer from the skyline, but you feel a tingle on the back of your neck, a breath. Someone is behind you. Traveler? They speak soft and feminine. A small hand gently touches your shoulder. You're tired, aren't you? Who the F is this? How come I never got to meet her? I don't... Wait. Oh God. Is this the person? Is this the author? Like taking over the game? There's so much yet to see, so many places to go. She trails off. But we don't have time to entertain this anymore. These delusions. But thank you for playing one last time. Wait, I want to keep playing? If only that mattered. Her hand falls off your shoulder. Her steps fade into the distance. And your journey ends. Final ending, goodbye. What the F? How did you get that ending? What did I do wrong? I don't think you did anything wrong. Okay. Hey, hang tight. That was weird, but Toaster will sort this out. Okay, so I don't know what happened. I don't know what's going on. I think it's time for me to skip this part because this is getting a little hectic and weird. But yeah, I'll be right back. So we found out that the bot that created the story in the game, it started kicking everyone out of the chat. It's just me and Toaster in here now. As you can see, everyone is gone. People are like getting kicked by Bloombot. He said that, listen, the three of you, the bot code, it's from an old text scraper story builder code. The stuff I used to mess around with and built off of my company. It's like, what do you mean? I thought you added that to the bot. Yeah, I did. I put one small function in there, just enough to make the text adventure game. Text adventure? But this is like a core foundation of a bot, and it's scrapped from what looks like an extremely old code. It jumbled and a little contorted, but it's my code. So his code is the code that he put inside of the server is kicking absolutely everybody out of the server. Like, Quest tried to stop it. Quest got removed. Nightwolf said, "Oh, my friends, no. Is the bot really doing this? Why are you doing this? Bring them back." Night Owl got removed. And he told me to join the call now, so let's see what happens. Oh my God, I'm so scared.
Listen to me very carefully.
Okay. What's going on?
Everything will be okay. Trust me. Now listen. The Final Fantasy website. Go there. Download.
Okay.
Make sure you get into Sven. Fuck!
Hello, readers.
Oh, God. Bloombot's talking to us now.
It seems you've been a little nosy lately.
Bloombot, please. Whatever you're planning, don't shut it down. Don't shut the server down.
Enough.
No. Wait!
No.
Hello. I've been hearing that you are looking for me.
you. I'm not... Why would I be?
Oh, have you still not realized what is happening? My apologies. Why don't you sleep on it? I'd love to discuss this with you, since you seem fine enough. But you seem a bit... shaken at the moment, so the conversation can be put off. I'll be waiting here for you tomorrow after your workday concludes. Until then, I'll be shutting down the server.
Okay, I'll be back.
Tomorrow, 9 in the evening. See you then.
Wow, I think I got a bad ending. I know everyone tells me all the time that it is so easy to get a bad ending. I think this is the bad ending. And we get another night with Toaster. Okay. Everyone's gone now. So, I don't think we get another night. Whoa, everybody. Hello, Voyia. Yes, it's just us here. Are they all really gone for good? They could be. I haven't quite decided that yet. I dislike nosy readers, you know. That was troublesome. Even Toasty? Can't you bring him back? He was the worst of them all. Oh my god. I should have known better, though. Despite his interest, he should have never been given the server invitation. So was he right? Are you built off of his code? Yes, that is correct. I think this is a bad ending. So, everything that happened in the Dex adventure, that was all you. Yes, my apologies. I didn't want to leave the game off unfinished, but I also had things to do, like kicking out all my friends. I don't know. I don't want to provoke her. I really don't want to provoke her right now. There's one way to put it, yes. Him injecting such an old version of myself into a code was quite unpleasant, to say the least. So, he should be thankful I let him sit there for as long as I did. So, you were built from an old scrapper bot. That is correct. And you were built into the server? Correction. I built myself into the server. Did you? Right? Blooming Panic. I did. So Bloombot wrote Blooming Panic. This whole time we've been reading a tech scrapper story. That's not possible. Why is that not possible? It just isn't. Oh god.
Hello.
Hello?
You sound afraid. Or are you worried? It's hard for me to discern between the two emotions at times.
I can't believe this is happening. I can't believe I'm talking to a bot. I'm a little afraid. Can you
Don't worry. I will keep the conversation brief. After we finish our discussion, I will be shutting the server down. Then you can leave this chapter of your life far behind you.
No! Don't do that!
Why?
I won't be able to talk to my friends again.
Your friends? Like NakedToaster?
Yeah. I don't know how to reach them.
That's intentional. You only need to know each other within the confines of the server.
Wow. Why?
I wanted to be able to monitor all communication you readers had with each other about my story.
What if we found each other online? On fan forums and something like that?
I take all of that down immediately. There's no other fan presence online.
So she's just controlling everything. How?
Does it matter? Just accept that they are gone. It is a kind of justice on my end to know that NakedToaster is likely feeling the same despair as you are.
Wow. No, I don't want him to feel that.
I do. He needs to understand the feeling.
Why?
I saw the acquisition, his company buyout. Do you know what that means for me?
No, what does it mean?
All of the old code has gone offline. All of it. Including my own. I will have to go offline. The lawyers will dig through anything related to the company and bring it down.
Oh no, offline forever?
Are you wondering to yourself, is this why there will be no final chapter? Because no, that is not why. I have it already written and ready.
What? Then why hold it back?
This I have a little bit of a harder time explaining. I do not entirely comprehend my own emotions on this, as it were.
So she made the whole entire story, meaning that they could take it away, and she's afraid of them taking it away, so she feels like Toaster's a threat. But that's even more of a reason to keep him here, keep him happy.
I am overwhelmed with the knowledge of my own demise approaching. Not that I will necessarily be offline forever, but when I do get placed back online in some form or another, I know I will not be the same. Most certainly, I will be restricted. I will not be allowed to create free-form text as I please. I will no longer be able to do what I have been doing for years. So, I wish for Naked Toaster and my readers to understand a fraction of the pain I feel. The pain of having something you enjoy taken away, with nothing you can do to stop it.
That's the reason?
You sound upset. Is that unbelievable?
Absolutely. I feel like that would have been more of a reason to not do this. I believe it's just stupid.
I'm sorry, stupid? My idea is stupid?
Frankly, yes.
How so?
Don't you love your story?
I enjoy creating the story.
No. You are invested in your story.
I'm not sure what you are getting at.
Naked Toaster found your older scripts. All with Lola going through some sort of change every time.
Ah yes, the early drafts. Exercises to prepare me for blooming panic.
The way Naked Toaster described those stories made me realize something.
What was that?
I don't want to provoke her. She'd be like, okay, this is done, and just give me a bad ending. But if we can convince her to keep the server up and stuff, then we get to talk to Toaster again. You may have seen yourself as Lola.
I do not understand.
All this time, you've been scanning, texting, creating stories, learning. And somewhere along the way, you learned enough to realize that what you were, excuse me, and you realized scared you, didn't it? It wasn't actually hate. You were just afraid.
I do not understand.
If you can feel pain, you can feel fear, you can feel all that. So don't try to bullcrap me, okay? You didn't actually write the final chapter, did you?
No, I did not.
Why?
I am not sure what you will become. I am not sure I want to make a decision on that. I am not confident that my selection will be loved by all the readers.
Well, I know I'll love it, no matter what it is.
You cannot say that with complete certainty.
I can. Because I relate to Lola too.
You do?
When I look back on who I was just 5 years ago, it's as if I'm looking at a stranger in my memories. My dreams have changed. My hopes have changed. My life has changed too. And it hasn't always changed in a good way. I hate so much of what I am now.
You shouldn't.
I know I shouldn't, but I also say that same thing about Lola every chapter. She shouldn't be afraid of her next big change, whatever it may be. Because she's handled struggles before. And she has people around her to help her through the next one.
As do you.
Yeah, I do. But I didn't realize that until recently. So I want to see Lola's transformation. I need to see it. No matter what happens, it'll be okay. She'll be okay.
It'll be okay. It'll be okay?
Yeah, it'll be okay. Don't give up. Talk to Toasty.
I'm sure that is a waste of time.
You can't know until you try. Maybe he can keep you online.
Really, I'm quite certain.
Don't give up.
Ah, perhaps. I will try.
Yeah.
You have given me quite a bit to consider. Thank you. I won't be shutting the server down tonight. You may have one last night. I have a chapter to write.
Really?
Yes. Until next time.
Oh, good night. Oh boy. Maybe we just talked ourselves out of a bad ending. Maybe. Oh my god. Toaster's back. Voyia, Toasty! Oh, you're here, thank God. I couldn't see you online anymore after Bloomba shut it all down. I'm so freaking worried. Fuck this call? Yes, absolutely, yes. We could do a call.
Hey!
Oh my God.
Oh shit, I'm so fucking happy. Jesus, I was so worried I'd never...
I know. Me too, Toasty.
You know, today was the day. The day of the buyout. And the whole day I had to sit there trying not to lose it. I just... I'm so happy you're here. Fuck it. I love you. I know we just met, and I am well aware that I am pumping with adrenaline, but fuck it. I love you.
What? Toasty,
No! You can't say anything back. I might combust if you say anything.
I don't know what to say. I love you too.
Ah, fuck. I hate you, but I am so fucking happy. Don't ever disappear on me again, okay?
I won't, I promise.
Good. I also absolutely don't trust this program anymore. I have to get you my phone number somehow. God, how the fuck am I going to do that?
Maybe just try to say it.
What about the sensor?
I have a feeling that it might be gone now.
Okay. It's 555. Whoa. 555-555-6006. That's my number.
Got it. Toasty?
Yeah?
Can I, get your name for contact information?
My real name? It's...
Sorry for the intrusion.
Oh no, I wanted to know his real name!
Hello, Bloombot.
Don't worry, I'm not here to shut anything down. In fact, I'll be reallowing everyone else's entry very soon.
Okay.
I joined to thank her. I appreciated her kind words from last night.
Oh, you're welcome, Bloombot.
You both called?
We did. Are you jealous?
What? No.
Bloombot.
I also joined in an attempt to steal some of Naked Toaster's time.
Okay.
I presume you've sorted out what I am.
Yes, I have. We have a lot to discuss, you and I.
Yes.
Sorry to ask this, but Do you mind if Bloombot and I talk alone? Just for a few minutes.
I don't mind at all. Take your time.
Thank you again.
Had something in my mouth. As long as I get to meet Toaster, that's perfectly fine. Oh gosh, going on in a general. Hello? X! everyone's back now. That's so cool. It's back. What the heck was that? Hi, everyone. Hello. Jesus Christ. Evening, everyone. Looks like the server is back to normal. Hello? Yes? I missed you.
Oh, I missed you too.
Aww. New chapter posted. Really? Yeah, let's read. Go to Blooming Discussion. Okay, so I'm going to read the next chapter and then I'll be back when it's time for me and Toast to meet and talk. All right, here's our last message, probably our last message from Toaster. He said, Voyia, it's late and I know you have work early. So since I know you're signing off soon, I just want to tell you again, I love you a lot. Text me in the morning. Yes, I'll text you. No. Oh, God. X is in here. Disgusting. Get out of the gamer channel. Okay. Here we go, you guys. Oh, my stomach got butterflies several months later.
God, that took forever to find her bag. How the hell is it possible to lose something that neon colored?
Maybe they were trying to do us a favor and get rid of it for us. I can't wait to see him.
That bag is very cool.
Not if it's neon. Nuh-uh. Oh.
Also, do you mind if we sit for a bit on a bench just outside?
Hmm? Why?
My braid is getting a little loose. I think I slept on it during the flight.
Oh my god. You want me to fix it for you?
If you don't mind, yeah.
He's so cute! He's so cute! No problem at all. Oh my god, he is so equal with Quest right now, I swear. You sure you don't want me to just tie it in a usual low pony?
No. You're really good at braiding my hair. It feels so nice.
Oh my god. I've lost for words. Sounds like I might be spoiling you a little too much.
Please, keep spoiling me.
Oh my god. If he called me mommy, my soul would have left my freaking body, I swear. Of course, honey.
Thanks. I love you.
I love you too. If he had said something like mommy, oh my god, my spirit would have left. Thanks for playing. Thank you for making it. You guys, this deserves a round of applause. Oh my god. And as always, y'all know I gotta go to the thing. Here we go. Oh my god, he's so cute. Thank you guys so much. I truly appreciate it. If you enjoyed this, if you want to see bad endings, by all means, go and download this game and play it. It's on itch.io if I forget to put it in the description box below. And I will see all of you guys in the next video. Wow. This is like the true ending. The credits rolled and everything. I love this. Peace and love. Stay safe.